Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Lazzarelli is COVID absent today. Councilperson DePena?
Here.
Rubiano?
Here.
Notary? Supposed to be on the phone. Councilmember Notary? We'll circle back. Councilmember Gervaud?
Here.
And Mayor Mellon?
Here. Pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States Republic, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Pledge allegiance.
Do we have Councilman Notary on the line?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States Republic.
Do we have Councilman Notary on the line? So can we mute whatever line that is?
No, you can't mute.
Do we have Councilman Notary on the line?
You can't mute them.
They have to.
We have Councilman Notary on the line.
Who? Who's them?
Can we mute whatever line that is?
Mayor.
Do we have Councilman Notary on the line? We have Councilman Notary on the line. Can we mute whatever line that is? Mayor.
What's going on, Robert?
He's good.
Okay. So we're at the point, I'd like to welcome you to our, let's see here, we are at our second meeting of April. This is our Tuesday evening meeting. So our next council meeting would normally be our daytime meeting, as I'll announce during my mayor's report. That one will not happen because of the municipal elections. Next item on our agenda is the Sunshine Law. Sunshine.
Pursuant to the requirements of the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, Public Law 1975, known as the Sunshine Law. Notice of this meeting was published in the Thursday, December 21st, 2023 editions of the Belleville Times and Star Ledger. The Sunshine Law was complied with by adopting and forwarding to the press, posting and filing with the municipal clerk the annual resolution showing the date, time, and place of the first meeting. A copy of the meeting notice has been posted on the township website and also the town bulletin board.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Before we move on to the report of the manager, we're going to deviate a little bit as we normally do during the council meeting when we have some official proclamations to present. So we have three this evening. I will handle the first on behalf of our Deputy Mayor, Mr. Cazzarelli, who is not able to attend today. I know we have representatives of the Elks, the Kearney Belleville Elks. Yes? I thought so. You're perfect right there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read the proclamation that the Township Council will pass today, and then I'll come down for the presentation, okay?
Thank you.
All right. It says, whereas the Benevolent and Protective Order of the Elks has designated May 1st through 7th as Youth Week in honor of America's junior citizens for their accomplishments and to give fitting recognition of their services to community, state, and nation. And whereas the Kearney Belleville Elks Lodge, 1050, will sponsor an observance during that week in tribute of the junior citizens of this community. And whereas no event would be more deserving of our support and participation than one dedicated to these young people who represent the nation's greatest resource and who in the years ahead will assume the responsibility for the advancement of our free society. And whereas our youth need guidance, inspiration, and encouragement, which we alone can give in order to develop those qualities of character essential for future leadership and go forth to serve America. And whereas to achieve this worthy objective, we demonstrate our partnership with youth and understanding of their hopes, aspirations, and sincere willingness to help prepare them in every way for their responsibilities and opportunities of citizenship. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Mayor and Municipal Council of Township of Belleville, New Jersey, do hereby proclaim the first week in May as Youth Week and urge all departments of government, civic, fraternal, and patriotic groups, and all of our citizens to generally participate wholeheartedly in this observance. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I
do eventually. We're supposed to have
them. One more? On three. One. Two.
Once again, congratulations.
As I mentioned, we do have three proclamations today. So the next proclamation we're going to issue is to a friend of mine. She's been a partner of myself and this administration for the past 6 years. She's somebody that has been basically, has served as an advisor to me in certain circumstances, and she's been a great partner. She's one of the reasons why we have our Veterans Day weekend, our Veterans Day 5K, and throughout the last couple of years, she's also hosted some independent events that I know that we participated in. And she is very much deserving of this proclamation. Miss Lucy Delgado, can I have you come forward, please? Whereas Lucy Delgado has been a distinguished member of our community in Belleville, New Jersey, and whereas her recent induction to the Army Women's Foundation Hall of Fame stands as a testament to her extraordinary dedication and service to our nation. And whereas Lucy has continuously demonstrated an unwavering commitment to the values, courage, dedication, and service, both in her military career and her contributions in our local community. And whereas her achievements inspire and uplift all who are privileged to know her or learn of her commendable life and career. Now, therefore, I, Mayor Michael Melham, Mayor of the Township of Belleville, do hereby express our deepest gratitude and appreciation to Lucy Delgado for her outstanding service to our community and to her country. Now, therefore, be it resolved that I, along with the members of the Belleville Town Council, extend our heartfelt congratulations to Lucy on this prestigious honor. Be it further resolved that a copy of this proclamation be presented to Lucy at a Belleville Township Council meeting on Tuesday, April 23rd at 6 p.m. as a symbol of our esteemed recognition to her and all she has accomplished. Congratulations, Lucy.
Official duties.
You're good. Okay. Yep. Okay. Thank you so much for this recognition. Yes, I was inducted several weeks ago to the U.S. Army Women Hall of Fame Foundation in Washington, D.C. Thank you so much for recognizing that and the work that I've done in the military, but also what women veterans do for our community. And it's always a pleasure to be part. It's a pleasure to be part of this community. We moved to Belleville 17 years ago, and it's only been welcoming, and it's been much of an embrace. So looking forward to this year's Veterans Day, and thank you so very much. I appreciate
this.
Thank
you so much. Next up is our final proclamation before we begin our official meeting, and that proclamation will be read and presented by Councilwoman Naomi De Pena.
Testing. Okay. I'm very excited for this one. I think this is the youngest person we've read one so far, and it's a huge honor because I've known this family for many years. Whereas the Township of Belleville takes pride in recognizing outstanding individuals who contribute significantly to the community through their talents, dedication, and service. Hold on a second. Let's call her up first, right, so I could read it while she's up here. So is that what we should be doing?
Yeah.
Yes. Let's call the family because I think Dad wants to take some good shots. Come on up. You guys want to come right here? And then I'll read it and we'll come down and then I'll take some pictures. All right. Whereas Sarah Joyce Santos, a remarkably talented young singer and a proud resident of Belleville, has been a beacon of musical excellence from a tender age, showcasing her extraordinary talents in singing. And Sarah has pursued her passion for singing with unwavering dedication and love, representing our town with grace and distinction at notable venues, including the prestigious Apollo Theater. Whereas on the 11th day of May, 2024, from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m., Sarah Joy Santos has been invited to perform at the highly anticipated Gospel Fest at Newark Symphony Hall, once again standing as a proud representative of our beloved Belleville. And Sarah's achievements not only highlight her exceptional talent and hard work, but also bring honor and recognition to our town. Sarah's achievement not only to our town, fostering a sense of community, pride, and union. Now, therefore, Michael Melham, Mayor of Township Belleville, Naomi DePena, Councilwoman, along with the council member, do hereby proclaim May 11th, 2024, as Sarah Joy Santos Day in the Township of Belleville. All right, so I'm told
that we have a very special presentation. We have to get our money's worth. We have to make sure she can actually sing.
So I believe Sarah is going to, she's going to sing us a song now, is that correct? Okay, well, congratulations, Sarah.
This is not the Apollo, so you can just relax.
The reason that I'm singing this song is because everybody in this world has trials, depression, and anxiety, and all these problems. But together, with God's help, we will all rise up.
Fine. Okay. Good start. This is like our flag raising.
Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but it's eating you, so we're gonna walk it out. And mountains, we gon' walk it out. And mountains, and we'll rise like the day. We'll rise unafraid, we'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again. And we'll rise up high like the waves, we'll rise up in spite of the ache, we'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again. For that be happy, though. And for that be happy, though. Yeah. We will rise, oh, we will rise. Whoa, whoa. We rise.
Wow. Good job.
Thank you.
Wow.
Great voice. Great job. Wow.
Next time she sings, we'll get the chief to play guitar. Wow, congratulations. Great job. Great job. We'll have a little battle. Wow, congratulations.
Yeah, we're not expecting.
Great job. Congratulations. That was a great beginning to our council meeting. Really was. We're going to pause for about 30 seconds. If you guys want to stay, you're more than willing to stay for the council meeting, but if you do want to leave, you most certainly can do so.
Yeah, the rest of it's not very
Congratulations. Thank you.
Oh my, yeah.
Wow. That was.
Congrats. Thank you very much.
I am. Okay, we're about to resume our meeting with the report of the manager. Before we do so, do we have Councilman Notari on the line?
I think so. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, John. How about Redevelopment Council Dean Donatelli?
I'm here, Mayor.
Awesome.
I'm here.
Okay. Took us a little bit, but we got it all dialed in. We're good. Thank you, gentlemen. Next item on our agenda, number 5, is the report of the manager.
Mayor, Council, I can assure you my report will not be as exciting as the last performance. So I can try to sing, but it's not going to work. So just a couple of brief updates as far as we're moving. This is the month where we start to do some very serious planning for summer camp 2024. If you remember last year, it was the biggest turnout that we've ever had, and we were able to add so many other components to the camp. We were actually sold out at one point, so we have applications ready for the camp counselors, and we have a packet just about done for the parents who are going to be interested in summer camp this year. So we're going to announce some pretty exciting trips, things of that nature. Also, we're very close to rolling out the Veteran Banner program. We had a great presentation. And the presentation, we're taking it to the next step. We have a meeting tentatively scheduled with all of the veteran groups because we want them to be part of the rollout as well, get their input. We're going to try to do it strictly solely on social media at first, see what kind of response we get. And then we may have to go to like a town mailing. But again, we're very close. We're working on that. We anticipate that very shortly. Also, this past week, we went out to bid for the 2022 and 2023 infrastructure on the roads. This is the money that we use to do some of the paving. I believe we have $3.5 million allocated. There are 6 streets: Harrison Avenue, Belleville Avenue, Washington, Maine, Sanford Avenue, Cortland Street between Bella Vista and Durham, William Street, Washington to Dow, and Mill Street. So those 6 streets are scheduled. We're also applying for some additional street money, so to speak, to do, hopefully to be able to add to this list. So that is my report. I'm certainly always available for questions.
Any questions for the manager based on his report? Anything? No? So I have a question just to follow up. I know that a few months back we had diligently work sessioned the topic and then passed some legislation regarding the Airbnbs. I know the rollout went well. However, enforcement has been a challenge. Do we have any update on where we stand with enforcement? And I'm not actually asking to put you on the spot in that regard. I have a question is really the way I should say it. My question is, the ordinance is pretty big. Who's responsible? So if I have a 4-family house and I'm the owner of the house and one of my tenants decides to sublet, is the tenant in trouble or is the owner of the house who might be unwitting and, you know, have no knowledge of what's going on? Who do we?
Whoever's actually renting the property out. So it would be the tenant.
So if we have,
because I assume the landlord wouldn't want
right
that as well. So
if we have a building that's owned by an LLC, say, and there's somebody that's subletting it, If the owner, which is the LLC, is not subletting it, we should be able to go after the person that's actually doing the subletting, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So therefore, I have more questions as to what's going on with our enforcement of that, which I guess we'll follow up at another meeting. Okay. I want to just clarify that because I wasn't necessarily sure. Next item on the agenda is the report of the mayor. Upcoming events next Monday, April 29th, is the State of the Township. That will be recorded and it will be made available. Transcript will be made available as well as the video the very next day for those of you who cannot be part of the live audience. Tuesday, April 30th, Estes County Home Improvement Workshop at the Senior Center from 6 to 8 p.m. Also on Saturday, May 4th, Estes County Home Improvement Workshop at the Senior Center from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. On Wednesday, May 8th, I will be teaming up with our 34th District Legislative Team to host a Senior Freeze information session. That will be held at the Senior Center, again, on Wednesday, May 8th from 12 to 2 p.m. Tuesday, May 14th is our Municipal Council election. Polls will be open from 6 a.m. to 8 p.m. Normally, that would have been a council meeting. However, even though now our council meetings are the next day, it was canceled. So therefore, today is the last council meeting for about a month. The next council meeting will actually be on May 28th, roughly a month away. Past events on Saturday, April 13th, Community Shred Day. I was there. Great job was done by all. We do that event usually twice a week. This past Saturday was a big event in Belleville, our Arbor Day celebrations. DPW did a great job handing out seedlings from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. at the Senior Center. And then our DPW director and Gabby did a presentation at our Pocket Park where the first 35 people that registered received a free tree. Seedlings are still available, and I'm not quite sure if trees are still available. That is it for past events. News, DPW has been doing a great job with our spring cleaning. They are doing their planter boxes as well as the front of Town Hall, which looks great. Saturday, we did our grand opening of our first cannabis dispensary. Very interesting, if you watch my social media, it seems like we got one set of feedback from Facebook and another set of feedback from Instagram. The long and the short of it is the township is eagerly looking forward to that 2% revenue. Just to give you some context, neighboring Bloomfield is going to be open up a few, but just from one dispensary alone, about $80,000 per month is the 2% revenue that they get from that. Just under $1 million a year, and that's from only one of them. So Belleville is looking forward. Amazing. Mr. CFO will be asking, the budget committee will be asking you for some numbers in a few months or so to see how well we're doing with that. Fairway Park, plans are done. They are awaiting DEP approval. Construction is underway down at Plant Zone Park. As you've seen, DOT has started and stopped and started and stopped construction along Washington Avenue. Just pay attention to township alerts on that. We are literally, we're just spectators in this whole thing. They kind of tell us last minute when they're going to do it and when they're not going to do it. Farmers Market is coming. Stay tuned to social media and township website. June 2nd through October 22nd, every Sunday at the Municipal Stadium Complex from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. And last, Belleville was recently just recognized for the third year in a row as a healthy community to watch, a very good award. That's it for my mayor's report. Next item on the agenda is the approval of minutes. Need a motion for March 26, 2024, and April 10th, 2024.
So moved.
Second. We have a motion made and second. Second. I think, second?
Yes, second.
Clerk, call the roll.
Yeah, that's what I thought. It was an odd, but it was.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Graziano?
Yes.
Calteri?
Yes.
Rubel?
Yes.
Mayor O'Malley?
Yes.
Minutes of March 26th and April 10th are approved.
Number 8, communications.
This is the final reminder for the deadline of filing the financial disclosure statements, which is April 30th.
Miller.
Final reminder.
Yes. I'm done, man.
The Township of Belleville received a grant in the amount of $1 million for the Main Street Improvement Project. So we have communication.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Item number 9 is ordinances.
I'm sorry, Mayor, before we go into the ordinance, I had a question on your report.
Yes.
Two questions. On the 30.
My report or the manager's?
Yours.
Okay.
On the 30, or this may be to Albert. On the 3rd, then our next meeting, because of the election, are we going to be able to have the communications, whatever we miss in the first meeting of the month, can we pull it together and have it together?
Sure.
Where the last meeting of that month has everything? You know, in the first meeting, we have communications.
You can always put it on. Yeah, you can put
conference.
Yeah,
you can conference.
Right.
Yeah, if you want to put something on, put something on.
I'm saying, you can put it on. So that's one.
Sure.
And then the second question for the marijuana.
Caucus.
For the cannabis, to Frank maybe, is when do we start reaping the benefits? How long after of that 2%? Is it this fiscal year?
Oh, yeah.
So that'll be, we can include that part of this year's budget?
So, two questions. I'll let Mr. Martino, since he has some familiarity maybe with Bloomfield, to answer the first question. If not, Frank? How soon we get the revenue?
How soon can you project it?
The monthly report monthly to the state of New Jersey turn up their monthly fee. Simultaneously, I assume, where they go to my
right.
They said they just cut the check to the college.
So monthly.
So it should be monthly that it comes in. The one time that does it quarterly, nothing wrong with that, but they report monthly.
So, and then I'm going to go on a limb and say that we could probably anticipate revenue from that for next year.
Okay.
Because we don't have last year's numbers as a baseline. Right.
And I'm with you. I just didn't want the perception to go out to say we're getting that here and right. Why not. That's all.
Yeah, no, we're not getting it this year. No, we're getting the income this year, but we can't project
numbers.
Well, we don't
multiple
know.
Numbers for next year.
Yeah,
so
you can't anticipate it.
You need history. That's one thing we learned recently. You need history to show.
To anticipate.
You need a history to show anticipated revenue, correct? You can't just make up a new thing and say, well, we're going to anticipate $1 million. You got to show it. So we're going to show it this year. Anticipate next year in a line item, I guess.
Anticipated revenue separate line item.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Since we're skipping our first meeting of the month, if any council member has a work session topic, we'll throw it on for the next meeting.
Discussion.
Okay. So that was it. Thank you, councilman. That was communications. Next is ordinances. Ordinance for readoption. This is the third or fourth readoption of this ordinance. I'm tired of reading this ordinance.
Do we need to do a public on this? We need to do public on it?
No, this is just a...
What do we do?
Is it a readoption for first reading or public or second?
Second. Final reading.
So this is going to be public.
Public, yeah.
It was a publishing error.
Correct.
That caused it to come back on.
I just like saying the word masseur. I just like saying that word. So order 01-24, ordinance for readoption. An ordinance amending ordinance 33-23, chapter 4, article 23, massage therapist, massage technician, or masseur of the revised ordinances of the Township of Belleville with a new chapter 4, article 23, entitled massage, bodywork, and somatic therapy. I need a motion to open for public commenting.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion made and second to open public commenting. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Rosiano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Robel?
Yes.
And Mayor Bellman?
Yes. Do we have any members of the public that have something to state or ask or about this particular ordinance and this particular ordinance only? Hearing none, seeing none, I will open up to the lines. Do we have anybody on the telephone that has a specific question or comment about this particular ordinance and this particular ordinance only? Hearing none, seeing none, I'll entertain a motion to close and move for final adoption.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion made and second to close and move for final adoption. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Rosiano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Robel?
Yes.
Mayor Melham?
Yes.
Ordinance
01-24 is finally adopted. Ordinance 10-24, ordinance for possible adoption. An ordinance to exceed the municipal budget appropriation limits and establish a cap bank. Need a motion to open.
Motion.
We need for open public, right?
Yeah.
So, second.
Motion made and second to open for public comment. And clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Rosiano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Robel?
Yes.
And Mayor Melvin?
Yes. We are now open for public commenting on this ordinance and this ordinance only. If you have a question, Frantantoni. Just state your name and address for the record, please.
Vincent Frantantoni, 129 Mount Prospect Avenue. As I do every year, I oppose this, especially this year when you're bragging about all the new revenue you're going to be getting, so there's no reason to exceed the municipal cap law and all that. So I guess you guys love taking money, but I think we should stay within the state caps.
Thank you, Mr. Frantantoni. Okay. We do have our CFO here. Well, I believe we do this
every year.
Every single year. Yeah. This is an automatic thing that we do every single year.
Right. And our CFO. You're not doing this for to exceed. You're doing it to bank the amount in case you need it.
In
two
case.
Years, a year or two down the line. It's a two-year carryover. You don't need it this year. You need to do the same ordinance to establish the bank.
Just in
you
case.
You do not need to it to exceed this year.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else for this ordinance and this ordinance only? Do we have anybody... do we have anybody on the phones for this ordinance and this ordinance only? Anybody on the phones for this ordinance and this ordinance only? Nope. Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to close, move for final adoption.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion made and second to close, move for final adoption. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Pena?
Yes.
Graciano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Ravel?
Yes.
And Mayor Melvin?
Yes.
Ordinance 10-24 is adopted.
Ordinance 11-24, ordinance for introduction, an ordinance to amend the revised general ordinances of the Township of Belleville, New Jersey, Chapter 8-16, entitled Handicap Parking Spaces. Need a motion to introduce.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion made and second to introduce. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Pena?
Yes.
Graziano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Ravel?
Yes.
Mayor Melham?
Yes.
Ordinance 11-24 is introduced.
Ordinance 12-24, ordinance for introduction, an ordinance approving the second amendment to the financial agreement by and between the Township of Belleville and 91 Terry Street Urban Renewal LLC. Need a motion to introduce.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion made and second to introduce. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Graziano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Ravel?
Yes.
And Mayor Melvin?
Yes.
Ordinance 12-24 is introduced.
Next, we have a public comments. I need a motion to open public commenting.
Motion open public.
Second.
We have a motion made and second to open public comments. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Graziano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Ravel?
Yes.
Mayor Melvin?
Yes. We are now open for public commenting. If you have a comment to make to the council, I'm going to ask you, please raise your hand. Once I call upon you, going to have you come forward. Please state your name and address for the record, and you have 5 minutes to speak on what we all hope is township-related business. Ma'am in the back.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sasha Rosario. I'm a resident at 394 Stephen Street here in Belleville. I have lived in the town for the past 20 years with my family. I am here to request that Stephen Street between Little and Bella Vista Ave be made residential only parking. Signature Fitness is a gym that has been open for many years and is open 24/7. Gym goers use street parking on Little Street, Cortland Street, Bella Vista Ave, and Stephen Street, as well as the three parking lots designated for the gym only. And it's very difficult to find parking when coming home from work or school. This is an issue that has been happening for some time now, and it's very hard. I'm a registered nurse. Sometimes I'm gone for 12, 13 hours and I come home from a long shift and there is no parking and I have to park super far and have to walk to my home. Here I have support from residents on the block signed. So this is not just only a singular issue. This is for multiple residents on the block. So we are requesting that Stephen Street between Little and Bella Vista be made residential only parking.
Thank you so much. Can you leave a copy? Is that a copy that we can have?
No, but you can have it if you would.
Okay. If not, you could just email. You want to email? If you email me, and that's what I was going to say. So thank you, first of all, for your comments. And thank you for coming forward tonight to have that conversation. We get a lot of parking related issues and concerns. And the best way that this governing body deals with it is we refer that always to the police department, which we will do now for you. So we refer that to the police department. Our traffic department will review the request. They will probably conduct some kind of a study and then they make recommendations to us. And then, as you see, just like if you were paying attention, what we did with the handicap parking, we kind of just say okay to their recommendations. So if you would be so kind to just shoot me an email tomorrow, I will send that email to the, I will include you in it, and I'll send that to the chief. He'll send that off to his team. And if they have any questions or concerns, that's the best way to keep the dialogue going. But thank you. I know that that area could be a problematic issue.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Yep. Frant Antoni?
Phil, it's Frant Antoni, 129 Mount Prospect Avenue. These Airbnbs, do they have to get a license to rent them out besides the tenant that they have in there?
So our new Airbnb ordinance does say that you have to be permitted to do so. There are certain houses that can, or certain buildings that can or cannot do it. They don't qualify. But if you do qualify, you still need to be known by the township that you're going to do that. It's a license. And you can't do it for one night. There's a minimum night stay and all that. Our problem, as is our problems in many areas, is just enforcement. We do have some violators that we've been having a lot of difficulty enforcing.
All right, because the reason I'm asking, I could see it on my block because I see the cars that come in with out-of-state plates, and they're there one night, and they leave. But my concern is...
We do need a...
You can't.
Yeah, but somebody in the background is playing.
Sorry about that.
That's why.
That's right. But my concern is that with all the crime that goes on, we don't know who's coming in. There's so many strangers coming into the neighborhood with the Airbnb and with the illegal apartments that are in the basement. The other night we went out. We had to go somewhere, come home. I couldn't get in my driveway because they park halfway in my driveway and halfway across the curb. I called the police station. In the meantime, my husband found out who it was, and they came out and moved it. He says, oh, my wife don't know how to drive. Well, then take the car away. She don't know how to drive.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll get in a fight about that.
Okay, and there's another concern I have. All these cable wires on the poles, okay? Mm-hmm. People put cable in and they move out and they have cable taken out, but the cable company does not take the wires down. You got cable wires that are not being used with the, I know that they give us money each year that because we let them use our air, our streets and stuff like that. Right. Can't we do something to specify if I move out, you have to take them cable wires out to the pole. My husband cut three of them from our house that were laying there, and they're still hanging there, a couple of them, from the pole. When we sold our laundry, there was over 100 feet of cable that he pulled out that the cable companies do not take the cable wires out. So maybe we can do something, talk to them, take the cable wires out. And as far as the cannabis place that opened, I don't know much about what they're selling, and I can care less, but it's still not, it was voted on by the people, but it's still not legal in New Jersey.
Thank you. Anybody else for public comment? Mario?
Mario Drows, 95 Bell Street. Just a simple question. Last town meeting, I believe you mentioned the apartments on Belmont Avenue that we got $500,000, correct, from the developer?
On where?
Which one? From Belmont Avenue.
Yes.
Yeah.
They gave us $500,000. Okay. The reason I'm bringing that up is because after I left the meeting, while they gave us $500,000, did the county take 5% of that money, or that was our end?
Oh.
After that, okay, because what happened, you mentioned also that there were four students going utilizing the school systems out of there. So I checked with the Board of Education. It costs $18,500 to educate a child. That comes out to $74,000. So you really only got $426,000 because the Board of Ed is getting is, well, actually, you got the money, but the Board of Ed is going to eat $74,000 the way I see it, based on that. The cannabis shop, were you the first customer by any chance?
I was there for the ribbon cutting.
I was just curious. I was just curious. I figured you were the first customer.
I was in. I don't know if that considers me a customer or not.
Okay, just going to move on real quick. You can answer me later. Resolution B, certain property. What is the address of the certain property? Okay, that's one. Resolution C, authorizing the Third Amendment for Terry Street. Okay, what does that mean? Because I looked it up on the board, there's nothing there. And the other one is, Resolution F, and I keep saying it. There's no reason, anybody could build what they want in town, but there's no reason we keep have to designating areas of redevelopment. So if you could just answer those three questions for me, I'm done.
Every day.
So B is, Resolution B? Is the old the wet property on Belleville Avenue. C, which is the Third Amendment. Do we have Dean still on the phone, our redevelopment council?
I'm here, Mayor.
Dean, can you just quickly go over C?
Yes, C is, as you said, C is together with the ordinance that was introduced tonight. That is to extend the completion deadline for the project on Terry Street to March of 2025 on a monthly basis.
Got it.
With the town receiving monthly payments.
So in general, just so the public's aware, when we do these financial agreements, traditionally they last about 2 years. After the 2 years, if the project is not complete, although it very rarely happens, the township would have the authority to essentially cancel the project or to deem them, what's the word I'm looking for, Dean? Deem them not compliant or, Brian?
Yeah.
No.
Correct.
Okay. Default. Thank you. So we could deem them in default.
Not my fault.
But we don't want to do that to a project that's 80% or 90% done. Complete. So what they do is Belleville, for the first time in history, has instituted the Graz line, named affectionately after Councilman Graziano, who's a member of our redevelopment committee. So basically now what happens is the developers pay us every single month that they're late. Why is that? Because we feel correctly that if they were completed, they would be giving us revenue in that pilot payment. So they're not. So in this particular, we have a formula that we use, so it's a little different for everybody. But for Terry Street, correct me if I'm wrong, it's about $17,500 a month. So every single month, they pay a $17,000 extension to us to extend it so we don't default them. Second, that we don't default them means they're open. It means that we're starting to generate some of that pilot revenue.
Through the chair, that's the corner of Terry and Cortland there?
Terry and Cortland.
Okay.
Right. And that project's been going on, by the way, since prior to 2018.
Yep.
For those of you who keep account as to who approves which projects, that one predates 2018. Anybody else for public commenting? Mr. Frantantoni.
If you allow me, I have an opportunity to praise again. I watched the April 10th meeting. I didn't make it. Can't make it during the day. But I want to thank Mr. Martino. There was a proposal to create an arts advisory committee, and Mayor Mellon didn't like it because he said that monster mural next door might not get be passed. But Mr. Martino, you defended the thing. And
Mr. Martino also said that private property is excluded, so that monster mural next door would not have been part of this project anyway.
If you let me thank Mr. Martino, because he said that our public property should be protected, and I agree with him there. In regards to Resolution F, and again, like Mr. Drow said, the funeral parlor and that house on 143 Valley Street is well-maintained. I mean, the funeral parlors is basically a historic place there. These are not areas in need of redevelopment. You're stretching the redevelopment law, like that last one that our great legislature approved, which just about says, do whatever the hell you want. It's a disgrace, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. But they're not, you're just accommodating these developers. And when we see the campaign finance reports, we know why. But it's another nail in Belleville's coffin. And you continue to do this overdevelopment. This morning was really outrageous, trying to get up Belleville Avenue from my street, Mount Prospect Avenue, Franklin Avenue. It's about an eighth of a mile. 8 minutes, bumper to bumper, never put my foot on the gas. It's just on the brake and idle forward. And none of these places are even rented yet. Imagine what's going to be here. You're destroying this township. Little by little. Also at that meeting, Ms. Bennett was talking about historic properties, and she's on the Historic Preservation Committee, and she said we're supposed to have a list of historic properties, and she emphasized loud, which we don't. Well, you most certainly do. When myself and Mr. Hinton and Evelyn, I forgot her last name, was on there, we have a list, and it's a list that we obtained from Essex County, which they did in the early 1980s and all. And it lists all the historic properties. In addition to that, we, the Historic Preservation Committee, had the Dutch Reformed Church, the Town Hall, the Reservoir, and I forget the other one. We had all the paperwork ready to go. And by the way, we attended two seminars in South Jersey at our own expense. We didn't ask for gas or toll monies and all. And we had all these resolutions ready to be approved. But the chairwoman of the committee at that time and two others who were appointed by the power people at the time decided not to show up. And for a year, we did not have a quorum. I begged the previous mayor at public meetings, please, we want to get this going. But there's certain developers who wanted things, and so they held us up, and they waited till our terms were up and didn't reappoint us. Now, another one that we have the list for is the rec house. And we have the whole history of it. When we did the 150th anniversary, we brought all these things up, and it listed. That was an almshouse dating way back to the 1700s. That's a historic site. Now, I know you got a developer who actually stood here and was salivating that he wants that property. We can't give it up. That's a historic property. It's our rec house. Our children need it. Stop destroying this town. Please, stop destroying this town bit by bit. Every meeting, there's something else that's really killing us.
Do need you to wrap up, Mr. Frantantoni. Thank you. Anybody else in public commenting? Anybody on the phone? No, sir. Mr. Ann?
Can you give me an update on this JR, the incident that we had with him taking the...
I have no
signed
update
down
for you. I'm not the police department. I have no idea.
For the record, state your name and address, please.
It's on the papers here.
Mr. Hinton.
State. You're Mr. Hinton.
For the record.
Name and address.
Oh, Gary Hinton, 307 Fairway Avenue, Belleville, New Jersey. It's on your agenda here, the item of JR's.
Okay.
So I'm wondering about an update when the guy was ripping my sign down.
The mayor and council don't deal with ripping down signs. It's not what we do. That's the feedback.
Okay.
Somebody's got it open.
I'm wondering about an update when the guy was ripping my sign. The mayor and council don't deal with ripping down signs. Not what we do.
Not what we do. Okay, let's start all over.
Okay.
Yeah. So do I have an update on you on sign? No, we're not the sign police. We don't get involved in signs, political signs. That would be a police department matter if you filed a police complaint.
I was talking to
this is not the forum to find out about an update on your case. That would be any time during the day.
Because it was on the on your agenda.
I don't know. You're talking about something that potentially may appear in closed session.
Mr. Hayden, that's in closed session and has nothing to do with your complaint.
Oh, okay. In closed session. All right. That's it.
Okay. Anybody else for public commenting? Anybody on the phones for public comment? Can they hear me?
Hello.
Yep. Anybody on the phones for public commenting?
Yes. Hello. I think there's two of us. You can go first.
Yeah, if you're on the phones, if you're not speaking and you're listening to the meeting, either on your phone or your computer, we do need you to mute that audio. We're getting feedback here.
Anybody on the phones for public comment? I can't hear them. I'm going to either room. Hello?
Yes, we're here.
Hey, criminal station, how are you?
We are well.
Okay, sorry I couldn't make it to the meeting. Just a real quick question. In regards to the township, state of the township, is that going to be posted on the town website or Bill Belleville Civic's website?
So the meeting will be videotaped. I'm sorry, the presentation will be videotaped. It'll be uploaded to either YouTube or Vimeo, and I will share the links on various social media channels and allow it to stream from my Civic Association website. I can forward the link to the township, and if the manager deems worthy to put it up on the website, it'll be on the township website as well.
Well, considering it's a state of a township, shouldn't it be on the township website?
I would say yes, but I don't want to take that position. So then you would be there sitting there saying that I'm making a political speech and putting it on the township website. So we'll let the township.
No, I mean, in my opinion, it's a fundraiser. You can call it what you want. That's fine. But if it is a true state of the township update, it needs to be on the town website because
sure.
It's advertised on the town website. But if it's a fundraiser for your civic association and your candidates, fine. Call it that, though. Don't call the state of the township, the state of the township.
Sure.
Speech.
Yeah,
call it a fundraiser.
Let me just butt in there for a second. The definition of a fundraiser would be to actually raise money. If the ticket costs $12,000 and the whole night costs $8,000 and you only raise $3,000 selling tickets, guess what? It's not a fundraiser. It's a loss. And if I was to do that at township expense, many people would be the first people to say that I'm using township money to give a political speech. The DJ costs money. The teleprompter costs money. The venue costs money. A lot of people, or I should say many people, would probably be saying it's wrong for me to use township money. So therefore, I am funding the entire thing. And a small $12 donation, if you want to be a part of the live audience, offsets the costs. It is certainly not a fundraiser because I can assure you I'm writing a much larger check at the end of the night.
Okay. Well, thank you for that clarification.
But I've also clarified that every year I've done it.
Okay. No problem. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else on the phone for public comment?
Yes.
Okay.
Lady Amparo, 57 Fairway Ave.
Okay.
So during your mayor's announcement earlier, you mentioned something along the lines of if people have been following your social media, then they would see information regarding the dispensary and stuff about that. So what do you say about those people that you have blocked? You clearly are known to post announcements on your social media, yet you continue to keep taxpayers blocked and unable to access these important town information.
So for sure,
this is the third time I'm asking you on the record to unblock the 44 people you have censored on your political page where you post townwide information and events. So what do you have to say about this?
I can direct you to the township website, which has a catalog of all upcoming events and all new stories. I could also direct you to the township social media, that shows the same exact stuff that I push out on my social media. Township taxpayers do not pay for my social media.
You mean to tell me if I go on my husband's phone right now and access your social media, I will not find a post that you posted, all the posts that you posted on your Facebook, I will see elsewhere?
No, because the township doesn't post political stuff. I post stuff about upcoming elections, and I post political stuff because it's not done by taxpayer expense. It's not a taxpayer-type funded account.
Right. So if I go to your page right now, there is no other townwide event that I will be missing because it will definitely post it somewhere else.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. I got that on the record.
Okay. Is that it?
Yep. So are you going to be blocking the 44 people anytime soon? Did you get a chance to review that court ruling that was just recently passed, as I have told you last meeting?
No, I have not reviewed it, and at this point I have no intention on blocking the few people township-wide that are blocked. And just so everybody knows, out of the list of people that are blocked, if anybody has a social media page or personal profile page, I have 5,000 followers on Facebook and about 3,000 followers on Instagram. I often get spam. I often get stuff of sexual nature. I often get people that pop into my comments and actually advertise diet pills and stuff like that. So to stop that from happening, I often do block those spam accounts. So when you hear numbers like 44 people blocked, it's not true. There are people within this community that I blocked. However, there's a whole bunch of people on my social media. Check out my Facebook post about the cannabis opening up that disagree with me, that I allow to be on my social media. They have the right to their opinion, to say and to disagree with me. I certainly don't block people that disagree with me. Go on my most recent Facebook post about the cannabis opening. More negative comments on Facebook and a whole bunch of positive comments on Instagram. But I most certainly would prove to you by reading those comments, there are plenty of people out there that have different opinions of mine that I allow to express that on my Facebook pages. And of those listings that you may see out there somewhere, many, many of those accounts are posting things of sexual nature, diet pills, gambling sites, and all kinds of stuff that pop up on my feed that are bot accounts that post comments within my post just to try and get audience. And I do block them to stop them from doing that. And that's why you see the overwhelming number of blocks that you see.
Okay, so one of those people is me.
Yeah.
So as I have mentioned during the first meeting, the reason why you blocked me, so it's clearly because I questioned your Board of Ed endorsement. So you blocked me for that.
I don't know the exact comment. I don't know the exact...
I have screenshots if you want me to forward it to you.
No, I don't need it forward. I'm just saying that there's reasons.
So are you going to be unblocking me anytime soon?
No.
Got it. Thank you.
Thank you. Time is up. Anybody else for public commenting on the phone? Hearing none. Seeing
motion,
none.
Motion to close.
Motion to close public commenting. We have a motion made and second to close public commenting. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Rosiano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Ravel?
Yes.
Mayor Malhap?
Yes. Next item on the agenda is resolutions, consent agenda.
Anything got to be pulled? Or?
No, I'm good.
I'm good.
I'm good.
Pull G.
Want to pull G?
Resolution G. We're pulling G. Need a motion to move the consent agenda with the exception of resolution number G.
So moved.
Letter G.
Second. Sorry.
Motion made and second. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember
DePena?
Yes.
Rosiano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Ravel?
Yes.
Mayor Malhap?
Yes. G.
Yeah, so I'd like to share or ask our team. So I, since our last meeting, I believe it was a month ago, I asked for a meeting and meetings in our committee, because Mayor Finney, we're all part of the committee. Haven't had anything yet, but I have, on the side, have went and spoke to Frank because I had concerns. Still do. So Frank was nice enough to sit down with me. And then I had questions because we did say, not put words in anybody's mouth, that the first reading, that was just to put forth, and then we're going to have conversation in the state and adopt accordingly. Haven't had anything since.
Well, wait, before you do that, Frank, have we heard back from the state yet? Okay.
Right.
So there's nothing since.
Right. So, but with that said, this is now a temporary, we're going to increase the temporary budget, okay, to go forward. Understood? And that's what this is about. So I had concerns. So again, Frank, a lot of information, great. We're putting baselines together, moving forward, happy with it. But again, questions. So if you all read the depth and breadth of this appropriations on every line item and the revenue that comes in and the details of year to date and stuff like that, to me, I see that there can be more in operating expense. There can be some cuts, if you will. And we still haven't had that conversation to go forward. And I know we have time, but again, these things keep coming up. And I just want to go on the record that we need to have this as a committee to do the right thing. We need to understand it, digest it, and move forward. Because I know it's all in our best interest, but we need to have it. And just not getting it. I mean, I'm looking at the numbers. I don't know if anybody looked at the numbers.
Our CFO is here. Frank, the budget that we adopted until this, that we introduced, until the state comes back to us, we traditionally do this to pay bills and such. Right. Is this something
like a
different
continuing resolution.
You always do?
Yeah. Right.
We know we're on the government, pretty much. So, to increase.
Hello, may I have permission to speak?
No.
No. Anyway, to the next, to get you to June, you would do another 25% if you wanted.
Right.
No point, we're pretty much done. So, I just raised the lines to where they're going to land as final adoption at this point. Say, listen,
so this,
we're going to have that meeting.
Right, so I'm not questioning that.
So this temporary budget is equal to the budget we're going to adopt.
We know we were going to.
Okay, so yeah, I'm not sure because you had said something about an increase. This is an increase.
No, no, I didn't say increase.
Yeah, you did.
Okay, I'm sorry if I said it's increase. Well, we are moving it up, right? The number's sliding up. It's got to go up, so it is an increase. Okay, that said, we still haven't had the conversation. Frank said we're going to have it. But if you look at the numbers, if you look at the operating salary and wage, we get it. We know there's whatever the percentage is across the board. Operating expenses, they need to be looked at hard because there are other, we passed some other line items, if you will, months ago, which I understood and I was okay with them. And we've had this conversation. But again, part of a committee and part of communications and moving forward to do our diligence, we need to have that. And to say, we're on target, what you just said, Frank, I'm not putting words in your mouth, tell me if I'm wrong, that, hey, we're good here. Well, we may be good because of the number and where we stand right now, but could we be better? And that's my question. And that's why I want to have this across the board. Questions on budget at the end of the day operating systems, I know salary and wages, others, a whole bunch of stuff that we need. I really believe that we need in a committee to have that. And I don't know if even when we have this conversation, this late in the game, if we did reduce it, can we go back and fix it? No. We have to wait till next year.
No.
Sure, we could?
We could fix it before we adopt.
You can always amend. You can always amend.
We have to do an amendment
regardless.
Okay. Regardless. It can always be amended.
This is where we are at the time of printing in terms of the line for the printing. You have concerns as a low E line that you want to look into.
And we,
and I'm fine with that. Mm-hmm. I will call the meeting and make sure that it I know you said you want to concern, like you want to look into it.
Yeah, and it's the committee I want. It's just not Tommy.
But
I think
this is the first I'm here, so send an email out. I mean, just as an example, last we were together on Wednesday or so, 2 weeks ago, we had some discussions about overtime and stuff like that. You were on CC on the emails where I was emailing.
Yeah.
So if there's a request for a meeting, just send an email to the committee. And I didn't know you wanted to meet.
Well, I know it was coming from. I know it was coming from.
All right. So are we going to have another meeting or? Okay.
Okay.
All right. Anybody else?
So correct me if I'm wrong. This is almost like a continuing resolution.
Yeah.
It helps us fund the government. Otherwise, if we do not do this, we shut ourselves
exactly.
down, and we all have a problem. We all have a problem.
I do understand that, but
and
again,
I understand what you're saying, but I'm not going to shut the government down and go to jail.
And I'm not looking to shut the government down. I'm looking to do our diligence.
Yeah. Yeah. I understand that. Yeah. And basically, you're limited by the prior year budget to some extent, correct?
You have to build off of that.
Exactly.
We can do 100% of it.
Right. But we're doing it in controlled.
Where we
Yeah.
It's just saving five resolutions.
Understood.
Rightfully so, but you understand my concern.
Okay. Good. Anybody else?
No.
Motion. All right. Need a motion to move.
May I have permission to speak?
No, I'm not sure who you are, but unfortunately you missed public commenting, sir.
Oh, and now it's the ma'am.
Ma'am, I apologize. You did miss the public commenting portion of the meeting. Unfortunately, it's just not permitted to speak anymore, or else we'd have to do it for everybody.
All right, next week.
Okay, good.
So I need a resolution. I need someone to move a resolution.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion made in second for G. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember DePena?
Yes.
Rosiano?
Yes.
Notary?
Yes.
Rovell?
Yes.
Mayor Melham?
Yes. Okay, new business.
So real quick under new business. So for everybody out there, Deputy Mayor Cosarelli lost his aunt. Mm-hmm. So that's why he's not here today. So just keep the Cosarelli family in your prayers. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so that was new business? Okay. Unfortunately, I'm going to entertain a motion in just a few minutes to go into closed session. Once we pass the resolution to go into closed session, we do have to clear the room. I will say that while we're in closed session, absolutely no action will be taken by this governing body. And when you're more than permitted to stand outside and wait for us to reconvene the meeting, but I will tell you that when we reconvene the meeting, it will only be to adjourn. There will be no action taken while we're in executive, and there will be no action taken when we come out of executive. So if you want to leave and not stay, you can. If you want to stay and come back in, you can as well. But at this point, I do need a motion to move to public executive session.
So moved.
Motion made in second. And the reason that we're doing that is for litigation and...
litigation.
Lease negotiation. Two reasons. And we have another negotiation. Three negotiations. Two negotiations and one potential litigation.
Possible litigation.
All in favor to go to